Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you viewers out there. That's what I was going to do. I can't find their actual clip they played, so I'll play this one. Some comments there, but people like this, I don't know why. I still would have most probably used the electronic didgeridoo, but I might have played it a bit better. Those of you out there that can't accept the fact that we're different people, and some people said, how do we know that each verse is different? Well, it's quite friggin' easy. One, sometimes people tell you that you're in a different verse. At first, many of us were like you, and I'm talking about the blue beards. I'm not even saying plural, because there are definitely more than one of us, because we sort of knew from pretty early that we thought we were being shifted into different verses, but we thought everybody else was just coming along for the ride, and then started to realise as friends started to change. People that we got to know all of a sudden were different, had different moods, different personalities, and it started to become aware to many of us. Our journal didn't start from the very first world that we jumped to. I don't know how many people exactly have been to this reality, and I don't know how many of us have been to this reality, but we have not had any correlation within the journal. One of us may have been here before the journal, we don't know. But since the journal, there hasn't been a double up of a person being here in this reality yet. And some of you, there's always a version of me wherever I am, because there can't just be one of me. This is what some of you need to accept. And this is why I think you still haven't grasped what the Mandela effect is. And I've watched some more videos, and I've been noticing that a few of them have been trying to clarify this. And you need to... I had some bad news a little while ago, and I'm just clearing my eye. It's quite weird that some things in one reality, as I said, I've had some bad news, and I'm hoping I don't get it in the next one, but the whole thing is, it's sort of everything is different. It's sort of, you go back through stuff, and like, I don't recognise any of the videos in this reality I've made similar. That's one of the things I do, is I look through these, I see if there's any that I have personally made. Yet I go back to the very early stuff, right? And when I say the very, very, very early stuff, we seem to all have been into the same type of research, seem to have same problems in reality as the others, i.e. with the sun and UFOs. We seem to have all done that. I made a video similar to that one, of that same guy, but different headings. I'm pretty sure I said different stuff about it. So they're not all the same, but they're different sort of thing. You know what I mean? It's hard to bloody explain, but the easiest thing to explain about the Mandela effect, the very easiest thing to explain about the Mandela effect, is the fact that we are shifting. And I mean, we are shifting. All right, we've all got similar subscriptions. And when I say similar subscriptions, we all tend to watch similar channels, and yeah, so we all sort of keep up. We watch some of the bullshitters, we watch some of the good ones, we watch some of the bad ones. And yeah, we go through and we look and judge for ourselves what's going on. But the biggest thing is you've got to keep track of what's going on, right? You must keep track of what's going on. And until you keep track, and I mean until you start keeping a journal and start to see the entries from the others, you're not going to know what's going on, because you're just going to think that the shit around you is changing. Right, that's the biggest fucking mistake of the lot. Too many of you out there truly think the shit around you is changing. Oh, they've changed this, they've changed that. For God's sake, wake up. You need to realise that it's not the stuff around you changing. It's you. You have been taken again and moved to another reality, another dimension, another whatever it is. Another planet on the multiverse. And I'll tell you now, the multiverse is huge, because I haven't come across the same planet yet. I look at this. This is always fucking different. Always. I watched in the other one where he's talking about two stars in the sky. And I've actually been watching, and lo and behold, out here there is apparently two stars in the sky here, but one's very hard to see. You've got to get it at the right period of time. I was just out there on dusk and I actually caught a glimpse of the second star. There is two stars in this reality. You want to keep your eye on it. You can actually see it at dusk. I couldn't see it earlier, but I can see it at dusk. It's really small. But apparently in the one before me, he said he came from a reality where you could see it as clear as a bell. And I was in that same video that he was talking about it. He was talking about New Guinea, saying something about this was destroyed in WW2. In my reality, that was still there. This is out of whack. I don't recognise this island at all. I do not know what the hell that island is. And by the way, this is the first time I'm actually looking at this. Myself and moving around, Australia is too far up, New Zealand is too far down, all those islands are out of whack, especially the Philippines, which the other bloke mentioned. So Korea's in the wrong fucking spot, Japan's definitely in the wrong spot, China is really, really weird. China's way out of shape. In the last reality, China was across, sort of like that, and it had Mongolia coming down. The other guy didn't even know Mongolia. So, Russia seems to be smaller in this reality. India, smaller. I've noticed that in a lot of the realities compared to the Sajo arm. On the Sajo arm, India's much bigger. Africa's way too big. Europe's definitely way too fucking small. America is out of whack, i.e. South America is in the wrong spot. South America should follow a guideline. You can actually see it on the planet. South America should be over here, come down there, and come down there on that white line. That's where it should be. The other bloke was in a different spot. I've noticed that is a quite a difference in a few of the vids. This is how I'm telling that there's different people. There's definitely not enough Hawaiian Islands. Looks like these have sunk, because there used to be about three or four more up here. It looks like they've sunk. Oh, hang on, no, there's one there. Is it? It's shrunk. One of the Hawaiian Islands has shrunk. Wow, okay, yep. Definitely, one of the Hawaiian's island is being beaten to shit by the waves, I'd say, and shrunk. Because there definitely should be more. That should be an island. That should be an island. That Nectar Island should be there somewhere, but okay, well, it's still there. Let's have a look at it. Okay, Nectar Island's way too fucking small. Way too small. Man, that's got inhabitants on it in my fucking reality. So, yeah, the thing is, it's sort of, it's got me beat on how people can think that there's only two of us. There's the one that was here and the one that's come here. Man, you've got no concept of the parallel worlds. If there's one parallel world, there's guaranteed to be another. I'm sorry to tell you, but there is. And it's called the multiverse. The multiverse theory has been theorized by every scientist that I know of, and I've studied it in every reality I've gone to, and they all theorize the same thing. In fact, that's what CERN, oh, I don't know about here, but that's what CERN's supposed to be all about, is trying to contact parallel fucking worlds. They're trying to talk to parallel fucking worlds. Well, in my reality, that's what they were trying to do. That was the whole purpose of CERN. Nothing else. It was to talk to other worlds. So I looked at something called Fermilab, which we did not have in my reality, which was another collider in the United States. They're doing the same thing. They had a little funny guy on a motorcycle riding around the collider. They're trying to do it in this reality. And so I don't know whether that's CERN's full risk thing. I found the Vistar website on this reality. We seem to all know about that. That seems to be a common thread. You'll find a lot of common threads. And I mean, you will find a shitload of common threads. This is why people think that it's the stuff around them that is changing. And it's not. It's you. You have to work out the key that tells you what shift is happening, when a shift is happening. And only you can work it out when the shift is happening. You can't, because your shift might be different to mine. I have had friends and made friends, and they have travelled with me on certain worlds. But then all of a sudden they vanish. Sometimes you think you've seen them again because they're friends again, but you see the differences in these people. Like on this one, a friend of mine, well, I couldn't find her in my Skype. A good friend of mine. Not in my Skype in this reality. So this is what gets me, and I've got friends that I don't sort of recognise. But the one thing I do recognise, all these fucking conversations, I don't know whether I have been part of a conversation or whether I haven't been part of a conversation, but I don't know. It's very fucking confusing. If anybody knows how to remove a conversation from Skype, please, please tell me, because I want to get out of these conversations. I've left the groups, but they still keep on appearing up on my fucking screen. I can't contact friends because these things are going fucking ring, 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 ring all the fucking time. Happened in my last fucking verse, and it's driving me fucking thing. I appreciate you teaching me everything with all your videos and making, I think I'm learning more from you than anyone else on YouTube anyway. I don't know, I wonder what was going on. Okay. Carissa. Yeah, Carissa. Honestly, the shit around you is changing. Yes, because you are changing. That's the best way that I can tell you. And it really is. It's the most simple thing of the lot, is everything around you is changing because you have been shifted to a new verse. I don't know whether it is a spiritual thing, whether it is our embodiment that is moving, right, or a physical being. I think it is our physical being. The others think it is our physical being. This is why we have been changing tattoos. And yes, I've got a very, very sore body part at the moment because I changed my tattoo with something else, and we've got a tattoo that can be changed in about 80 ways, and not all have the same thing. We're actually marking in the journal where we're changing this tattoo, and keeping track of it, and hopefully the others in the other verses haven't had the same idea, because then it could start causing a few problems. But the thing is, it is spoken about in the other journal, the tattoo. Are we following each other? That's a question someone did ask me. Are we following in a pattern? No, I don't know. Hopefully we were, because then I can get an idea what the freak was going on. So you've got to ask yourselves, is it us? Is it our body? Is it our soul? Is it our mind? I don't think it is our mind, because if anything, it's our soul. And is it a way that we're learning from God? There's a great possibility that this, and I have spoken about it in one of the other two videos about how I had thought that we had died for a while. For many jumps, I had thought that we had died, and these were, the jumps were a way of God teaching us that, one, we were dead, two, that the universe is bigger than we thought. Maybe this is how we get to interface into the universe when we get along and everything like that. Now, another one said, oh, I don't believe you anymore. Well, I don't personally give a shit, because I don't know how long I'm going to be. So, but you've got to expect, if you think that there's only one of us or only two of us, you need to wake the fuck up. And yeah, I swear like the others. I just don't swear as much, most probably. I don't know. I haven't experienced everything yet. I'm still trying to experience. I'm only through about three pages of the first... Well, sorry, not the first book, the last book. I haven't even gone back to the first book yet. I have skimmed through it, because, trust me, it's a big book. And it goes bigger and bigger, because every one of us writing, I've written in it already. And what my last verse was like, and i.e. what I'd read, some of the stuff that is thing, how the other guy was freaked out about something. So you get to know each other and you learn from each other, especially if we find out something. Right? Well, I haven't read anything in the journal about the visual acuity thing, that where I'm getting that funny, weird pattern, which I still haven't put into the thing of that video yet. Because of the thing... Hang on, folks, I've just got to do something. By the way, somebody else asked, well, how do you always know where the website is and all that? Guess what? We got a Word file that never closes. It's always there. It's always the first one when you open up a Word file. That thing is always there. So that we know where it is, what to put in, everything. It's in pretty much every version that we have been through and seen everything and looking for stuff and everything. So, yeah, we make sure everything is right. Make sure it's only the newest comments that come up. So those of you out there that are trying to explain what the Mandela effect is, I'm going to make that the thing. You've got to realise that it's weird. It's weird as all shit. It really, truly is, and I don't like advertising for people. So those of you out there that can't work out what's going on, it's weird as all shit. By the way, I thought this was the one of the reasons why they were putting this out on Microsoft, because they've got a full channel of this shit, by the way, of all CG stuff of the end of the world shit. And I thought that this was what fucking happened, and that's one of the reasons why I thought we all fucking died. So it's weird. So those of you out there that still haven't worked out what is going on, I just found the fucking opening credit. Yeah, about that. Oh, okay, I found the opening credit. So now I know where it is. It was hiding behind a clock. So anybody out there that doesn't accept what is going on, I feel very, very sorry for you, because one, you're missing out on an experience. Two, you don't know what's really going on with you. And if you think that the shit... Oh, check this out. There's got a hidden skeleton in this picture. Never saw that before. Check it out. There's a hidden skeleton in here. Right in there. There he is. In there. Artists that hide shit. I'm one of those artists. Yeah, I was on a world where I wasn't an artist, by the way. started painting something, and one of the family came over, and it sort of freaked them out. Oh, here I am painting a beautiful painting, and apparently the version of me that was there had never ever painted before, and they'd never ever seen any of his work. Things are different, things are the same, and I'm getting that from a video that I watched. Now, the whole thing is, those of you that do not know what is going on with the world and what is not going on with the world, well, yeah, it's fucking weird, very weird. And to those of you who don't know what this is a vlog, this is how I keep track, this is how others keep track. Unfortunately, our channel turned into this for a reason of the shit was happening to us. So, yeah, it's really, truly weird what is going on. No one knows. Anybody knows, please tell me, because I'd love to know what the fuck is going on. All I know is the effects of what is going on. And I'm learning to cope. We have all learned to cope with it. Our journal helps us to cope because we see the changes. We know we are shifting from universe to universe. Whether or not I did have a theory about two verses ago that the whole galaxy is, oh, not the whole galaxy, the whole universe is exactly the same. Every universe, every galaxy structure is exactly the same structure. And that's where the parallel verse resides. But after looking through my telescopes and everything like that, because we're all into telescopes, thank God, because I'd miss that, and it's one way of keeping track of the sky. I'd noticed some differences in each one, so yeah, that's not the same. But someone did ask me, how is if we've shifted from one side of the galaxy to the other side, how do we know that, and how we got the same constellations? Because if you looked directly flat across the galaxy, any galaxy, you're only going to see a cluster of stars. You'll see a big smoky cluster. And all the star constellations that you look at and view on a regular basis are outside of the galaxy. So one side of the galaxy, you see them from one angle. The other side of the galaxy, you see from the other angle. I'd go into more detail, but I couldn't be bothered at the moment. I'm still reading. I'm just sort of responding to some comments and some stuff, because I'm seeing people that really do not have a handle on the Mandela effect. Haven't got the slightest clue of the Mandela effect. Everything around them is just changing, and they think that's what the Mandela effect is. They think they are the same person on the same fucking planet. Got some bad news for you. You must probably change worlds 30, 40 fucking times and just haven't realised it yet. So, yeah, that's the scary part. So, wake up and start to open your fucking eyes, and you will see that you are moving and shuffling and moving and shuffling. Oh, there's something else in that thing besides a skeleton. Looks like an alien. Oh, I just saw that one. Yeah, it looks like there's a little alien behind the skeleton. And he's got a suit on. Is there something behind him? Oh no, he's got, okay, well, maybe it's something evil, I don't know. But it's definitely in there. Look, check this picture out. I strongly recommend, while I'm doing this and yakking, watch this picture. Check this out. Tell me what you can see in that picture. I can see a few things. I was just seeing another skeleton to the side of it, actually. Yeah, there's a few in there. So start again. So there's a skeleton there. There's actually three skeletons. And there's something there. Under there. Check that out. So, so you've got to review and study and research. And by you keeping notes for yourself, you will eventually start sharing those notes and start working with others. I haven't yet met up with the others from the last reality yet. And I'll know if it's them because they will tell me it's them. And yeah, so those of you that have yet not discovered what the Mandela effect is, guess what? You got a lot to learn. So it's really, really hard to explain in a small video or a long video because I've been gone for God knows how many jumps now, and I'm still learning about it. I do know that I am the one being moved. I am physically different in many ways. When I say that, it's because I go to a reality where they don't have my medications and I've got to go and get them again, and that drives me nuts, number one. And number two, I look at all the shit and go around and look at all the people around me and see them change. And so, yeah, you get used to it. At first, I thought I was in the fucking Tony show many ages ago. I thought, oh, yeah, they're fucking pulling on the new Truman. Yeah, well, guess what? I'm not the new Truman and you're not the new Truman. It's actually really fucking happening. It's happening big time, guys. And if it is the Tony show, similar to the Truman show, man, have I got a fucking lawsuit for you cunts. Sorry, ladies. Oh, I'm very, very sorry. Language wasn't a problem in the last verse where I was. Pretty much everybody swore over there. So those of you out there that are still trying to understand it, yeah, start learning, because if you think that it's just you that is, you know, all of a sudden and all the shit around you is changing, you have got quite a lot to learn. You really, really do, and I'm so sorry. And that bloke that I deleted his comment before, don't want to watch my videos, man, you don't have to. Yeah, you really don't, because they're not mine. I've only started making videos here today. So those of you out there that are trying to understand it, learn to understand it, because this shit is really, truly happening, folks. And if you are seeing differences, if you are seeing a minute difference, you have moved galaxy, universe, dimension. I don't know, because I'm still trying to work it out. So, those of you out there that already have worked it out, keep your journals going, and eventually you will see compliments from the other. You could be in one verse for a week, you could be in two verses for a month. You don't know. Sometimes you might only be there for a week. Lately I've been shifted every 4 to 5 days. So, yeah, you don't know. But there's signs and things and tells, and there's that picture that I showed you. I get it every time I shift. Every single time. It's what tells me that I've moved again. Get to know people. Get to establish people. Get to taste good Chinese food. Get to taste shitty Chinese food. Get to taste nice food. Get to do this. You get to do that. And there's a lot of differences. Get used to it. Enjoy the ride. But I can definitely tell you're not in the Truman Show, and you're not in the Sally Show, you're not in the Bobby Show, you're not in the Tom Show, you're not in the David Show, you're not in the Ken Show, you're not in the Bruno Show. Yeah, guess what? It's called the Mandela Effect. Oh, and one thing here, this is really strange, okay? And all the other worlds that I've been to, right? They've got a ABC for Kids channel, right? And I like everything else. I watch cartoons, and I watch a few cartoons on that. We've got a few good ones on it, actually. I first saw the narwhal on what was it called? Almost Naked Animals. Funny, by the way. I don't know if they've got it here yet. I haven't looked into the TV shows yet, but it's, guess what it's called on this reality? Guess. I bet you can't guess. M-E. M-E. And this channel, on all the realities I go, has got a lot of stuff that sort of you only see on the ME effect, i.e. the narwhal and stuff like that. Different shows, and yeah, fair enough, they're kids shows, but like the Bernstein Bears and shit like that. I don't know if they're on here in this reality. They were in the last two for me. I never saw Bernstein Bears until I sort of watched an ABC for kids, but then I get to this reality and they call ME. Really fucking weird. Really fucking weird, folks. And if you're in this reality in Australia, yeah, think about it. And you're watching ABC for kids, in this reality it's called ME. Why in the fuck is it called ME? And it's got narwhals on it and other shit. What's going on with the Mandela effect within this fucking channel? Really fucking strange. Kids Jumping Dimensions. What was that show called? Nowhere Boys. They jump dimension. Right? On ME. Yeah, real fucking scary. I think they might know about it somehow in this reality. I am yet to find out. So I'm going to go back to reading the journal. I've got to go and finish cleaning up after some puppy dogs, and because they're outside having a run around and I can feel a cold breeze coming on, so they're going to be yelping in a minute to come inside. And I've still got to wash their blankets yet, so I'm going to catch up to you all later. And yeah, enjoy yourselves. I might put another video out tonight, I don't know. I've got a bit of homework to do. I've got some assignments, thanks to the last bastard, he didn't do anything. Yeah, so I've got to do some work for the college, and thank God I've already done them in the other verse, so I know what I'm doing. So, all of you out there, I'll catch you all later. Bye.